So now let's dive into understanding what an image gradient is. To help us define an image gradient, let's take the example of this sample image again. What we're interested in is at each and every point, we want to compute the gradient and with respect to the neighborhood that we are in, traversing in again the both dimensions of the image. A gradient basically is defined as a measure of change in an image function. So at this point, what are the changes of the image function with respect to how things change in the x direction, or in this case, the columns, or the y direction, the rows of an image. We'd like to be able to compute this both in discontinuous and the continuous form. So how do we define it mathematically? So basically, the differential of the function f, which represents an image with respect to x, and then differential of the function image f with respect to y, and of course, both dimensions of this represented by the del f is the gradient of the image f. But in essence, this is the way to measure the change in image function f in both x and y. Let's look at that with a couple of simple examples. Let's take a simple ramp image here. Starts with the dark values, let's say 0 to 255, where the pure white is. At this point, I want to be able to measure the change of this image function as respect to how it is in this neighborhood here. Very obvious, if you take the same function here, you notice that all of the change in this direction is for the x direction, none for the y. So, of course, this is a very simple case where you can just represent the del of f is nothing else at this point to be this function here. The counter, of course, is when there is a pixel and actually it's now, or this image here has a ramp here. And, of course, going from 0 to 255 from this point onwards. And in this case, we can simply look at that there is not going to be any change in the x direction, that seems to be fixed, and just in the y direction. Combining these two, we can look at if the changes are in both directions, then there will be, of course, the gradient direction would be at an angle, which is theta. In essence, what that basically means now is that the gradient points in the direction of the most rapid increase in intensity. From here, the intensity is increasing rapidly in this direction, less so in this or this direction. So this is my most dominant angle. Let's look at this a little bit more carefully. How would we compute the gradient direction? Just take the inverse of the tangent. I mean, this is my vector, del f with x and y. If I know the y and the x changes, I can basically now do the inverse tangent to get theta. The magnitude of this vector, which would of course be the modulus of this value here, which would be the square plus square, square root. So if I have this thing, and it'll give me the magnitude of the vector. So the angle of the vector and the magnitude of the vector are the ones we're looking for. And that would basically define the gradient at any point in an image. So while we're at it, one thing I want everybody to think about is how does this relate to edge direction? When I have a point here and I have the gradient direction here with theta and the magnitude, where is the edge? Hopefully you'll have that answer in a bit.